Hello and welcome to Amulya's Academy YouTube channel. Today we are going to solve a coding problem called longest substring, and it is one of the most asked interview question. Here is the problem statement. Given a string S, find the length of the longest substring that contains no repeating characters. So input of our program is a string and output is an integer number, that is the length of longest substring. For example, here we have a string. In this, the length of longest substring is 4. Here you can see all the substring without repeating characters. Then in that, the length of longest substring is 4. A substring is a consecutive sequence of characters within a string. And here we want to find the length of the longest substring. Here to solve this problem, we will use sliding window approach. This approach uses two pointers, left and right, to represent a window of characters in the string that has no repeats. We slide the window by expanding right to include more characters, shrinking left when a duplicate character is found. Little bit confusing, right? Don't worry, let's take an example and we'll see how to use this sliding window approach to find the length of longest substring in the given string. Alright, here we have examples. The first string is this. So let's find the length of longest substring in this given string. First, I'll write down my string like this. I'll write down the character's index also like this. Then, in this sliding window approach, we'll take left pointer and right pointer. First, let's expand the window by including more characters. So first, let's take the first character, that is A. So our character is A. This is our window. We need to take left, right pointers. Here we'll take left pointer as the index and right pointer as the character, like this. Here right pointer is equal to character A, left is the index. And here I'll take another variable, that is index. So initially it is 0. Here index of this character is 0. Left is pointing this now. Right is also pointing to this. This is our window now. And also, this is a substring of this string, right? So we need to calculate the length. So I'll take a variable called length. And here now length is 1. It contains one character. So length is 1. How to calculate the length? Here index is a number. Left is also a number. Right is a character. So we can't use right to calculate length. So we can use index and left. So I'll use this formula, index minus left plus 1. Initially, now index is 0 and left is 0. 0 minus 0 is 0 plus 1. So length is 1. We'll get length as 1. Next, we need to expand this window. For that, we need to include another character, that is the next character. Here next character is B. Its index is 1. And now right is pointing to this character. Here right is B now. Index is 1 and left is 0. We need to increment left or change the value of left only when we encounter a duplicate value. Now our window contains A and B, no duplicate values. So now length is 2, that is index is 1 minus left, that is 0, 1 minus 0 plus 1. So we'll get length as 2. Next, let's expand the window again. Next character is C. Its index is 2 and right is pointing to this character now. Here, right is C, index is 2. Now, C is not a duplicate value. Our window contains all unique characters, no duplicate values. So, let's find the length. Length is 3 now. Let's update length 3. Next, let's expand the window by adding another character. Next character is A at index 3. So, now right points to A, index is 3. Now here you can see A is a duplicate value. In this window, from left to right, A is already present in this window, right? So A is a duplicate value. To find the duplicate values, let's create a dictionary and let's add all the visited characters and its index like this. A is visited at 0th index, B is visited at 1st index, C is visited as 2nd index. Then when we pick a new character, you can compare it with this dictionary. If I call this char dictionary, character dictionary, then we can see that character is already present here or not. If it is already present, then that means that character is already visited. Next, we need to check whether that is present in the current frame or not. Here, yes, A is present in the correct frame and it is visited at the 0th index. So now what we need to do is we need to shrink the window. So for that, we need to remove this from the window. Let's increment left value. Now left will point to this value. What we need to do is you need to check the index of that duplicate value. At what index it is visited? It is visited at 0th index. Then you need to point the index of next character. So left becomes B. Now right is A and index is 3. And if I do index minus left plus 1 now, so we'll get length as 3. Now here we need to update its index. A is seen at index 3. Next, we need to expand the window by adding another character. Here another character is B at index 4. So now right is B, index is 4 and left is pointing to the index 1. Now let's see whether B is already visited or not, whether it is a duplicate value. Yes, B is seen at index 1 and it is present in current frame. Right here it is present. So what we need to do is we need to shrink the window. Now left will point to this. So left value is index 2. It is B, index is 4. Now calculate the length. Length is same 3, right? 4 minus 2 plus 1, so we'll get 3. And also we need to update this value. B is seen at index 4 now. Next, let's move on to the next character. Now the next character is C at index 5. Right is C, index is 5. Now whether C is already visited character or not, whether C is a duplicate value. Yes, C is already visited at index 2 and it is present in current frame, right? So what we need to do, we need to remove that from the window. Now our left points to index 3. Why? Because C was seen in the index 2, so we need to increment it by 1. Here C was seen at 5 now. Update this. Length is same, 3. Next, let's expand the window by adding another character. Here that is D at index 6. Now D is a new character. It is not a duplicate character. It is not visited till now. So we now have in the window A, B, C, D, and we need to add that to this D at 6, a new character. Then now let's calculate the length. Length is index is 6 minus left, that is 3, plus 1. So length is 4 now. Next, let's expand this window by adding another character. So another character is here B, 7. Now the character is B, index is 7. Now, whether B is a duplicate value, it is already seen at the index 4 and it is present in this current frame. So what we need to do? We need to increment left pointer. We need to move the left pointer. So it is seen at index 4. We need to increment that by 1. So now left will point to this value. Why? That is because B is seen at 4. We need to add plus 1 to that. It will point the next character. Here B is seen at index 4. Now left need to point to the 5th index. Here left will point to this 5. We need to remove this from the window. Now we have C, D, B in the window. The length is 3, but previously we got length as 4. We want to find the length of longest substring. The length of previous substring is 4. So I won't update the length value because I want length of longest substring. Till now, length of longest substring is 4. So I'll keep the length as 4. So while calculating the length of longest substring, if previous length is greater than current substring length, then we need to keep the previous length because we want length of the longest substring. If length of the previous substring is greater, then no need to update this. Okay. Now B is seen at 7. So let's update this. Next character is at index 8, that is A. So right will point here, A at index 8. Now let's see whether A is already visited. Yes, A is seen at index 3, but it is not present in this current frame. It was visited previously, that is at index 3, and now left is greater than index 3. Left value is 5. So it is not in this current frame. First we need to check whether that value is already visited. Yes, it is visited, but it is not present in this current frame, current window, right? So no need to consider it as a duplicate value. In this window, it is not a duplicate value, right? So while checking for the duplicate values, we need to check for two conditions. One is whether it is already visited. We can check that by using this condition. We need to check whether that is present in this dictionary or not. And another one is whether it is present in the current window. It is not a duplicate value in the current window. Now, CDBA, there is no duplicate values here. Let's calculate the length, that is 4. So length is 4 and A is seen at 8. So let's update this. Okay. And next, let's add another character. Now the character is C. Let's expand the window. Character is C at index 9. Right will point to C. Now C is already visited at the index 5 and it is present in this current frame. Here you can see. So what we need to do? We need to increment the pointer, left pointer. So left need to point to 6 now because it was seen at the index 5. So left here, left value is 6. Now DBAC, all unique characters, no duplicate characters here. So let's find out the length. Here length is 4. Previous maximum length is also 4. So we'll keep that same. And C is seen at index 9. So update this. Next, let's expand the window, but we don't have any character. So we are done. Now the maximum length is 4 here in the length variable. So the length of longest substring in this given string is 4. We need to return this value. Okay. To find the length of longest substring, we need left pointer, right pointer, index, also a dictionary which will store visited characters as well as its index. It will store when it is last seen. Then we want length variable to calculate the length. For that we'll use this formula. Next, here we have another simple example. Let's see how it works. ABAC, let's take the index, left pointer and right pointer. Here you can see the process. Okay, now I hope you know how it works, how we can use sliding window approach to calculate the length of longest substring. Next, let's write the program. In the Python file, first let's define a function. I'll take my function name as longest SS, longest substring, and S is the parameter, that is the string. Input of our program is a string, so I'll take parameter as S. This function will return an integer value, that is the length of longest substring in the given string. Right, here first we need a dictionary to store the visited characters and its last seen index. Key is the visited characters and value is last seen index. Then we need length also, so I'll take length variable and initially I'll take it as 0. Initially length is 0. Then we need left pointer. Initially it will be 0. Left is 0. 0 the index, first index. Next we need index of every character as well as we need characters one by one. So for that I'll use loop. I'll take index right in enumerate function and S. What we are doing here is we'll use enumerate function so that we'll get index and its character one by one. So initially index will be 0. Character will be the first character, for example in this string A. Inside this, for every character we need to check whether it is already visited or not. For that we'll use if condition. If right points to the character in the string in character, and also we need to check that duplicate value or that character is in the present window. For that we'll use the condition like this. If both the conditions satisfies, then that means we found a duplicate value in the current window. So we need to increment the left pointer. So we'll take left is equal to that duplicate character index plus 1, right? If not, if it is not a duplicate value in the current window, what we need to do is, first we need to update its index. We need to add that to character dictionary. Character dictionary right is equal to index. So if it is not a duplicate value, what we need to do is we need to add that character to character dictionary here. That is, we need to mark that character as visited, and also we need to add its index. We need to know at what index we have seen this character, right? For that, we'll write like this. Next, we need to calculate the length. Here, to calculate the length, I'll use max of length or index minus left plus 1. That is, to calculate the length, we'll use this formula. And we'll store that result in this length variable. But if the previous substring is longer than the current length, then we need to take that length, the maximum length, as the current length, right? So that's why we'll use this max function. If the length, previously calculated length, is greater than the currently calculated length, it will take this length as the our maximum length. If it is not, if newly calculated length is greater than the previously calculated length, then it will keep newly calculated length. We just want the maximum length, that's why. And we need to do this for the every character of the string. Then we need to return length like this. Simple, right? Next, let's call this function. Let's take string as ABC, BCA, BCD. Okay, then let's call longest SS, and also we'll print this result because this function will return a value, an integer value. Here you can see length is 4. Let's take like this. Here you can see length is 3. You can print this like this. Here you can see the output. Okay, so this is about how you can calculate length of longest substring in the given string. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.